I can't believe that you always suck like that, but I don't know where to hide the bat.
Well, you've never complained before. Hello and welcome to Tangents of Horror.
You could have
Look at that. Yeah. I'm a poet and I kind of know it.
You're kind of a jerk about it.
No, I'm so nice.
Just about your poetry.
Exactly, because it's so sweet and innocent. And welcome to Tangents of Horror. My name is Brandon.
And my name is Steven.
One day you'll get that right.
One day.
Like, you'll be able to say it properly. We just got back from the movies.
Guys, what did we watch? Tell us right now.
Yeah, what did we watch? Time for you to guess.
They suck at this, dude.
Oh, I don't hear any answers. The Blackening.
We watched it.
It was, we did.
We had
the
private theater. We rented it out for ourselves.
That was great.
Oh.
We didn't even sit where we were supposed to. We were rebellious.
Right at the front row. Beautiful.
Well, the front row before the front
area. We would never.
And it wasn't like an IMAX theater where that would not have been a good spot. Yeah. It was like the smallest of all the theaters in the place, which I'm not complaining because the front row had the bars right there.
Yeah, we rest our little feet on there.
Oh, that was fantastic. Oh. My legs were up the whole time and we didn't have to pay for the VIP.
It was great.
Recliners.
Yeah, we just pushed ourselves back. We watched The Blackening.
It was great. And here we are. We'll see you later. Go see the movie.
Yeah.
Directed by Tim Story.
Yeah.
Who has directed stuff that we know.
Ride Along 2. Fucking
Taxi. The Fantastic Four movies. Yeah. Like the original ones from early 2000s.
Yeah.
Not the reboot. He did the newest Shaft movie from 2019, which I think it was a reboot, because I'm pretty sure Samuel Jackson was in another Shaft movie in the 90s. That's the one with this kid.
He produced this one in Shaft.
Also executive produced.
Oh!
So he got all
produced
the jobs.
And directed.
Taxi, this guy, Barbershop. This guy's got a great little resume going. And he directed this one as well.
Fun, really fun flick.
Really fun.
I love the comedy writing a lot.
It stars a bunch of people: Grace Byers, Melvin Gregg, Jermaine Fowler, Steven's favorite, X-Mayo.
X-Mayo's a fucking crazy name.
That is a cool name. Antoinette Robertson, Cinqua Walls, Jay Farrow, I can't remember his name, and it's not in my notes, but the guy from the Drew Carey Show was in it as the Officer White.
Oh, he was from the Drew Carey Show?
Yeah, he's one of Drew Carey's friends.
His the little badge, the name tag on that guy's uniform said B. White.
Oh, so it was actually his name.
Yeah, it was his name.
I thought he was just like going along with the joke or some shit.
Drew Carey Show guy.
Yeah, he was also in, is it Dodgeball? Or
he looked a bit older.
It might be Joe Dirt.
Joe Dirt?
Yeah, there's one scene where he's giving like an instructional class on self-defense. Maybe it's not even one of those. It's like a Saturday Night Live movie, but he's very America.
Oh, okay.
So he has America pants on, like the flag and shit.
Yeah.
And he's teaching Deirdrick Bader.
How do you pronounce that?
Deirdrick?
Honestly, your guess is as good as mine.
Yeah, he played Oswald on Drew Carey.
Ah, there you go.
One of his like goofy, stupid friends. So good. I love seeing him pop up in chicks. He's not in a lot.
Now, what did you think about the opening in The Blackening?
This was a great opening.
Yeah, to two characters. We thought they were going to be our main guys.
Which was great.
Yeah.
It was very Scream-like.
Very much so.
Very
yeah.
Scream-like. We have our two. I think these people are the ones that were throwing this. It was like a reunion, we find out. Because they're setting up stuff.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
Oh, interesting. Oh, okay. So I guess they were.
And when everyone like gets there, they're They thought they were coming later for some reason, but they had already set up. It was very strange.
Okay. Yeah, because I thought the main girl's name, Morgan, they kept referencing.
Oh, in the beginning, Morgan and Sean.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, Morgan, it's funny because every time a door squeaks, they get they get scared throughout the whole movie. Someone gets scared.
Yeah.
Which is nice because usually in horror movies they just look at the door and check out. Everyone in this movie is very like not hesitant but very
level-headed.
Cautious.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
Where they're just like, I'm not going there.
Yeah, she's setting up for a party. She hears the door creak, and her boyfriend does the classic, just like hey babe, but like touches her shoulder. Yeah. She just bashes him in the face. Yeah, good little jump scare.
Elbows him in the nose. Go, why the hell? I'm in a cabin in the woods. Why the hell did you not announce yourself walking into this room?
And that was great. There's a lot of references to the stupid shit that people do in cabin movies.
Yeah, they specifically say, we're in a cabin in the woods, like multiple times.
And then what happened? Like, how do they get to the game room?
So,
they start wandering the house.
Yeah, that's right.
And they see the green door.
Yeah.
And
then the boyfriend says, I closed that. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I left that open before.
Yeah.
Which is funny because later on, I think every time they see that door, something's different about it.
Because
later on, there's no sign on it. Mm-hmm. And then someone says the door was locked, the door isn't locked, and the sign is on it. But yeah, it's just like a little storage game room type thing. Like the stairs go down like four steps. But we find out that the blackening is like Jumanji.
Yeah, yeah.
Sort of. It's not very... Yeah. We find out it's not... It doesn't actually have any powers.
It's a bit of Saw.
Yeah, that came later. Because in this scene, we don't get the TV. The TV doesn't turn on.
Right, it's just the voice coming from the game.
Yeah, and do they answer any questions? Or no, the lights just go out and
I remember it asking one question.
It asks one, yeah.
It went over my head, though. I forgot what the question was.
But
essentially, the board game is features this little black-faced fellow who's speaking to them.
Sorry, I think I remember what the question was. I think this was the question that asks, which horror movie does a black person survive?
Mm.
And he says, what's Will Smith's wife's name?
Jada Pinkett Smith, Scream 2?
Yeah, he says Jada Pinkett Smith and her boyfriend from that movie.
Yeah.
And Morgan's like, no, you idiot. They're the first kills, which is funny
because
I'm thinking about it now.
Yeah.
That's what's happening in this scene.
Oh, interesting.
They're the first two people to go, and they reference the one movie where it's blatantly two black people that die first. This movie did great on that. And then the lights go out because they answer wrong, obviously. And we should mention this board game had like the talking head on it is like an old like 40s mascot when things were racist.
Yeah, yeah.
Is it blackface?
Yeah, it's straight up blackface with the big red lips. Yeah.
So right away, it's funny because every time they find the game, like a new group or whatever, someone's always like, oh, hell no, I'm not playing that. And then someone else is like, well, it's a game. We gotta play it.
No, both times someone mentioned, they're like, oh, I hate this Jim Crow shit. But yeah, and then we get the first introduction when the lights turn off. They're kind of looking around of the arrows.
I was waiting for something to come out from behind him.
Right. Yeah,
especially with the mask the bad guys use.
Yeah.
That would have been cool coming out of the dark. But you just see an arrow go by. You don't even really see what happens until later when you see him on the TV screen. You see like his throat.
Oh, yeah. I guess so. Well, we see it. I think the girlfriend puts her iPhone flashlight on him. And then we see
a little bit,
yeah. Yeah, we see blood coming out of his mouth, and he says his line as he's gurgling on his blood, yeah. And then we cut to the title card.
We can say half the line. He says run, and of course he says you would assume they would say in this movie.
In the movie called The Blackening.
Yeah. It was great. And do we see him catch her, or it just cuts away?
No, it just cuts right at that point, yeah.
Because we find later on, very Saw-like, that she's actually been captured and kept alive.
Yeah, yeah.
So then we get...
We get introduced to the three in the car, I believe, or two.
Yes, the car.
Yeah.
No, the three, because the two girls in the front and then
the gay
friend, which I actually thought he was with the girl.
Yeah, me too.
They make it seem like because there's one person from this group of reunion that went out with the person driving and apparently just kept cheating
on her. No, she wasn't. I think the gay guy was driving. The two girls were in the passenger because they exchanged glances.
But yeah, apparently this guy kept cheating on her, so they mentioned that there's going to be eight people, and he's like, wait, I thought there was going to be seven people.
Yeah.
And they're like, this is what the first time also we get the talking through...
Yeah, exchanging glances, the way the gay guy puts it.
Which is funny, which makes sense, because girls always, you always say
they can communicate
glances, but now they use it as like an actual...
Telepathy.
Telepathy,
telepathy is moving things, isn't it? Reading, mind reading.
I think it can be a...
Telepathic communication.
Yeah, telepathy. Yeah, there you go. Telepathy.
Yeah, yeah.
Same
that works.
Area of expertise.
Yeah, so we actually get the girls saying lines to each other as they're just staring at each other with their mouth closed. And honestly, it gets used like two or three more times in the movie. It's really cool.
So at this point, I thought he was with her. Because he's like, he's going to be jealous of someone. And obviously, it's the person they're thinking of.
Yeah.
Then we cut to two more characters. Well, one more character. Yeah. She's stopping off at a gas station.
My favorite ex-Mayo, Shanika is her name.
Oh, was this ex-Mayo?
Yeah, this is ex-Mayo. Okay.
She was cool. Yeah, she was funny. She's like one of those, like, doesn't give a shit. I'm going to say whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
And she's in a gas station. The one, because when she pulls up to the gas station, it's so funny because she's rocking out to the music and shit. And you just see the white, like, redneck old guy sitting out front the gas station, which we find out later is kind of part of the whole story.
Yeah. He's just shaking his head.
He's just watching her for like a good minute and then just slowly starts shaking his head.
It was such a really well done scene, too.
And then so she goes into the store. The store owner starts staring her down.
Yeah, yeah.
We find out it's the son of the dude that was sitting out front. That comes way later. Although we did see it technically. Because in the beginning, when Morgan is setting up the party, there's a picture. Because I guess the old guy's the one that owns that cabin
It's like
an Airbnb. And rented it out.
Yeah.
Yeah, because even the cop says, usually, what is he? It started with a C, Mr. Camden or something like that. Usually only rents to certain folks. Yeah. And they're like, white people? And he's like, families. White families?
Yeah.
So I'm assuming that was him. But even because I thought throughout the film, it was going to kind of be one of those like
Get Out?
Sort of, but kind of like they bring the white or the black people in to kill them off every however many years.
Yeah, yeah.
But then you find out it's one of them that actually set this whole thing. A lot of twists and turns.
Yeah, honestly,
I thought that was great.
I liked it. Yeah, so she's in the convenience store. She gets her wine. The one-eyed store clerk
just like stops at the end of the aisle. Yeah.
But you can pass it off like, oh, store clerk's watching me buy stuff. That's a black person. And then she's like, ooh, wrap snacks. I didn't know those existed today. I thought those were like from the 90s.
Oh, probably. That's probably why she gets so fucking excited. And she grabs like a bag of every flavor.
Yeah.
We didn't have those in Canada, did we?
I don't think so.
They didn't look familiar.
No. Yeah. And then
she bumps into
our nerdy guy. What is his name?
Is it Ferdy?
No. Ferdy was from the shopping mall one.
Oh, right.
Clinton?
No, that's what Clifton.
Clifton,
because someone calls him Clinton. Someone calls him Colin. And I'm sorry, but I kind of called that he was in on it.
Yeah.
Like I sort of knew as soon as they got to the cabin, ex-Mayo and him.
Yeah.
And everyone who met him sort of didn't know who he was.
Yeah.
So I thought, number one, they never knew who he was.
Mm-hmm.
Or two, he's mad because
of something. Yeah.
He wasn't noticed.
Yeah.
Which it kind of ends up being the opposite.
Yeah.
He was like put on fucking show.
Yeah, yeah.
In front of all these people. But yeah, this store scene is funny. I love it. And he is actually my favorite character out of them. Because he's actually the only person, like they're all acting. But he's the only person like putting on like a face and a voice and like this whole nerdy.
Yeah, like a very like Steve Urkel kind of character.
Yes, thank you. That's right. And I was actually thinking if anyone's ever seen the movie Bowfinger, Eddie Murphy plays a famous actor.
Yeah.
But then he also plays his twin brother.
Oh, cool.
Who has like glasses and kind of talks
nerdy,
like that and shit. And it reminded me of that like 100%.
And then, so then
they meet the other two, like when the first three people get there that we saw in the car, they meet two more people out of the group, one of them being the ex-boyfriend.
Yeah, the ex-boyfriend.
He's a big boy.
Big, muscular gym trainer, it seems.
Yeah, he's a gym trainer.
So it's him and his best friend, assumedly.
Yeah, and his friend, we sort of find out in Pat, like sort of small talks, he was like a gangster or thug that always had guns. And, and now he's all peaceful because right when he sees them... This is where we meet Mr. White or whatever. And he's like, because they don't have the paperwork.
Oh, that's right. They immediately stopped him.
Yeah, because he didn't have paperwork or keys or anything. And then they show him and he's like, sorry about that, blah, 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 blah. And he's like, oh, just a little bat of energy, namaste or whatever.
Yeah,
and they're like, what the hell was that? How you doing?
They're like, who is this Gandhi guy all of a sudden?
So I think that's everyone at the cabin.
Yeah.
Like, the two other people come later.
They get established, and then this is where we're introduced to the game room for a second time when she goes puts her bags away. Morgan, I believe.
Does she go into the game room?
No, but that's the door at the end of the hall.
And there's no sign on it at this point.
But the lights are on, and she does see movement behind it.
That was cool. Well, she doesn't see it because she passes it, and then
we see the
two feet.
Shadow.
I love that. That was cool.
It's cool. And then, and so she tries to the Locke and then the ex-boyfriend that so the gay guy and the ex-boyfriend have a beef.
Yeah,
because the ex-boyfriend cheated on her.
Yeah,
in the
he
past.
Goes to like give him a high five, and he's like, "I gotta go get my bags."
This isn't Morgan, is it? Her name?
No, Morgan's the girl at the beginning that was killed.
Yeah,
or not killed, but taken.
Yeah, this is what is. I need to know her name because she kind of plays a main character. We have the cast list right up here. Allison.
Yeah,
Allison. Yeah,
yeah. Allison's the one that has the Adderall.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
Yeah, because I forget who brings it. I think it might be Ex-Mayo. She brings a big bag of drugs. But no, it can't be
Allison
her.
Allison gives the Molly to the gay guy.
Is it Allison?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Because, and she's the one that's made fun of for being mixed as well, right?
Yeah, because her dad's white.
Yeah, her dad's white.
Because she makes a comment about being afraid of him
or
whatever.
I'm scared of white people. Yeah. She's like, but your dad's white. Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah, whenever he gets angry, I think he's going to do murder suicide, she said.
Yeah.
Yeah, so she checks the door. Door's locked. And then her and the ex-boyfriend have a little talk, and she's like, hey, come on, watch out. And then what do we cut to? We cut to the spades game immediately.
Yeah, they're just kind of partying, drinking.
Yeah,
some of them are playing spades. I've never heard of this.
Me neither. Well, it's a black game. Why would we know?
It's a card game. I figured everyone.
I know, right? A little drinking game. But this plays a major role in the plot itself. So they're.
Yeah, which was cool. Yeah.
So they're the four of them are playing spades, and it seems like.
This is when the two show up.
I think. Have you ever played the game Signal? It kind of gives me vibes of something like that.
Wow.
Yeah.
I haven't thought of that game because I didn't play it like religiously, but I remember at least a couple summers or something playing it probably at cottages.
Yeah, because the two girls were kind of using their telepathic technique to win at this game.
Oh, yeah.
Because they're like, girl, what do you need? I needed this, a spades, this, a clubs, or whatever. And
okay.
Then they end up winning the game because of their telepathic
ability. Their glances win them the game. But this is when the other two show up.
Yeah.
Not Clinton.
Yeah. Yeah.
Is going around. Yeah, Clifton.
Yeah.
It doesn't help that it's not a name that you hear on a day-to-day basis. He goes around. He's saying hi to everyone. Everyone's like, hey, Colin, no Clifton. Oh, yeah. And I can't remember what excuse he says. I think they just assumed he was around in college.
Yeah, well, they said, oh, I haven't seen you since.
Well, yeah, because they feel bad, right?
Yeah.
And they didn't. Like I said, they didn't put this together.
Yes.
It was so if Morgan and her husband were still there, they would have known that he wasn't supposed to be there. So I think that's why they took them out first.
You're right. Yeah.
Big brain thinking.
Yeah.
Good going,
and
Clifton.
And so Clifton asks if he can learn spades.
And they say...
And they say no.
Yeah, they basically say, like, if you don't know it already...
Yeah, just watch.
You're not...
Yeah, we don't.
You're not good enough to play. Plus, it's a
2v2.
2v2. And at that point, they were playing guys versus girls. And the girls were like, oh, we'll get the guys to teach you. And even they were like, no, just watch. If you get it, you get it. If you don't, whatever.
Yeah.
So even right there, they're trying not to be dickish to them. But that, like, college.
Yeah, it's just like.
Their youth is coming out a little bit.
Yes, very much so.
Because most people would just be like, watch whatever. For a hand and then maybe get in on a hand.
Yeah, exactly.
And, but they're, like, trying to keep them out. I forget how they get to the game room. Do the lights go out and they start?
I think they see the sign. The lights do go out and they look for the fuse box.
Yes. And they finally see the sign. Yeah. They're like, that sign wasn't on there before.
And then they take off the game room sign. They go in the game room and the lights turn on. They're like, oh, so the lights just turn on by themselves?
I like that.
Yeah. And so once they go into the room, bang, the door closes behind them and they are stuck in the game room, Saw style.
And that's, we also see the TV here.
Yes.
Which is a sick TV. It's like old, like 50s TV.
Yeah.
The game turns on. They start to, one of them finds Morgan's necklace in the house.
Oh, that's, the earring.
Sorry, yes, earring.
Yeah.
Which was one of the game pieces.
Yes.
In the beginning when they were playing.
And even the main girl we see in the opening.
Mm-hmm. Morgan.
Not Morgan.
No, that is Morgan.
Then why didn't she say anything about her boyfriend dying that she showed up with?
What are you talking about?
Oh, Morgan was never there.
Morgan's kidnapped
right
now.
That's right. Morgan was never there.
Yeah.
Okay, makes sense.
Yeah, so it's Lisa and Allison that are in the game room.
That's right. Okay.
And Ex-Mayo.
Yeah.
I like that name more.
It's so good.
It's such a cool name.
Ex-Mayo.
They should have just left that in the movie, to be
honest. Honestly, call her Ex-Mayo.
So yeah, they're in the game room, and then they have to start answering the questions.
Yeah.
And they get most of them right.
Yeah, they put all the game pieces on, and then they start asking black history questions to see who's the blackest.
All the game pieces correspond to like their personalities, which is pretty creepy, which right there, well, even in the beginning when Morgan picks up her earring as a game piece, I knew it was going to be someone within the group.
Wow, Scream. It's always someone you know. I'm just reading it right off your poster.
Right. Well, this is 100% inspired by, like we said, Scream, Saw. Yeah.
Cabin in the Woods movies.
Oh, 100%. Yeah. It just didn't have like the paranormal part to it.
Yeah, exactly.
But it still felt that way sometimes.
Yeah, because the game board was very creepy. They did that really well.
I'm assuming they were just talking through it from the control room.
Yeah.
That's my best bet. So yeah, they're answering all the questions. I can't remember a lot of them, but the funniest one to me anyway was the one... They did get right, technically, because they're asked how many black people were
Friends?
On Friends.
Yeah, they're all
name,
like...
name five people,
Black
people, black
people
and they actually
Friends.
Get through all of them, and then the board game just says, no, you're supposed to say that you don't watch
Friends. Yeah, I didn't
Friends.
Watch that, I watched something else.
That was great. It was such an intense scene, too. Like, who's the fifth one? And they're all trying to figure out, and then they get it, and you're like, yay. And it's just like, no, why? You're not supposed to watch that show. What's wrong with
you? Throughout that, they're all being very coy about it, too. They're like, oh, I didn't want about this one time it was on. No, I did see
it. Well, I think it's ex-Mayo and maybe the gay guy are having, like, the most in-depth conversation.
Yeah, that's right.
And everyone's like, I thought you didn't watch it. I was like, no.
And the big jacked guy kept saying, wait, you guys all have watched this?
Oh, man.
And yes, that's right. Because to force them to play the game, the TV shows Morgan in a chair all binded up and everything.
This part was fucking hilarious. Because he had something attached to her head to scalp
attached
her.
Attached to her hair.
To scalp her.
Yeah. So it was supposed to pull her hair and scalp off. And then
it turns out to be a wig.
Yeah.
And she actually starts running away.
X-Mayo goes, that's some good weave glue. Yeah, so the door unlocks and they all run out at this point, right?
Yeah.
To go look for Morgan?
Yeah, because she's obviously, well, not obviously, they would assume she's somewhere in the house.
Yeah.
They're running around and they end up hearing
from the basement.
Well, no, I think they try to escape first because this is when they throw something at the glass and it doesn't break.
Right,
and then they hear the knocking at the basement door.
Yeah.
This part was fun. Like, this movie was hilarious. I'm just going
to
say it before
bits.
Rating it.
Yeah.
It was funny.
Yeah, the bits were so... Because it didn't stop. Yeah, we immediately go into... So the living room TV turns on and shows a live feed of Morgan going up the basement stairs. And so they're
doing... So there's a telephone line.
Yeah.
Like, there's three people going around from the TV to the door.
Yeah, and they're doing the trope of watching the movie and, like, yelling at the movie even though they can't hear. So our main...
But it's like, the guy's coming behind you, next person. The guy's coming behind you. And then they're at the door. Morgan, he's right behind behind you. Oh my god, he's coming up the stairs. Holy crap, he's coming up the stairs. Morgan, he's coming up the stairs. And then they end up, well, not they, what's his name? I think they called him King or something. The guy that used to be a thug.
Yeah.
Does end up having a gun in his backpack.
Yeah.
And he's like, Morgan, step back. I'm going to shoot the door. Yeah. I thought they were going to just end up killing her.
I know, right?
I don't think we see what happens.
We do not. So Morgan just kind of disappears.
Because when they open it, it's dark and he just starts shooting arrows.
Yeah.
But yeah, he starts shooting the door. I thought maybe the bad guy was going to come up the stairs and just hold her as they shot and then kill her.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. I thought that would have been cool, but yeah, we don't...
We could actually assume that happened.
We can.
Yeah.
And I'm going to say this right now. That was my biggest problem with this movie is we didn't see a lot of deaths.
Yeah.
Most of the ones we did see got old fast because it was just all arrows.
You know why? 14A. This was a 14A rated movie.
Oh, 100%.
Yeah.
But even they didn't have to make it even more bloodier. Just change them up.
Oh, yeah.
A couple arrow
deaths.
Yeah,
because we got arrow.
Maybe a knife death.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe it's a cabin. Like, there's so much to work with, right?
Chandelier.
So that was all.
There was no chandelier.
Oh, wait. That wasn't this. It was also Chopping Mall.
Yeah.
You said chandelier. So all of a sudden, I saw the shot of the chandelier that falls, but then we don't see it go anywhere. No, but yeah, then. He shoots the lock. They open the door. It's just pitch black.
Yeah.
And this was a cool part, too, because all of a sudden you just see the arrows. It would have been a really good 3D movie.
Oh, yeah. You know, these arrows coming at you.
Because every time the arrows came, it was always...
Right towards camera.
Yeah. And it hits
King.
King.
Yeah. Right in the shoulder.
He finally... he pulls it out, which is very ballsy because they don't end up being arrowheads. They're just pointed.
Yeah.
But if it was an arrowhead, he could have ripped shit out of his body.
Terrifying.
And all through this party, he finally gets it out, and one more arrow goes. Everyone's in the way, and they move, and it hits him right in the exact same spot.
And he mentions it later. He's like, "I got shot twice, but one hole."
He says, "I got shot once." They're like, "No, you only got shot twice." He's like, "Same hole. There's only one hole. I got shot twice, one hole."
And then they end up pushing the door back on the villain, and that's such a funny scene with ex Mayo and the gay guy as they're pushing the door back and slapping his hand. It's trying to open it up, and then they.
This was great because then they end up stabbing his foot.
Yeah, they delegate,
which is also funny because they tell I think it was Lisa to get go a get a knife, and she's like, she's one of those like giddy people under these circumstances.
Yeah.
And even when she brings the knife, ex Mayo's like, "Okay, stab him." She's like, "I don't want to stab him." She's like, "God damn it, give me the knife!" Like stabs him in the foot, and I like that comes up later
because
the first person they end up killing. That was something they say it in the movie, but that was something I saw right away.
Yeah,
it was his boots are too clean. What happens after this? So they run away from this.
Do they get back to the game room?
They do get back to the game room at some point.
Arrow shot.
No, because when they were in the game room before exiting, they had no. It wasn't the friends question. I don't think because they do the blackest person in the room and they send Buddy out.
No, that's the second time.
Oh, is that the second time?
Yeah.
So that must be one of...
Yeah.
Like, they get back to the game room somehow.
Yeah, exactly. There wasn't even...
because they can't find a way out because they realize that it's basically
all barred
a prison.
Off.
It's all barred off. The windows are unbreakable.
Yeah.
So I think they end up going back to the game room somehow.
For the second round of gaming.
And this time... They're just basically asked to sacrifice someone.
Yeah, they're like, "Listen, I'll let you live, but just give me the blackest person in that room, and you all have to vote for someone."
And they go through some pretty fucking hilarious points because all of a sudden, when it's life and death, they all turn on each other.
Yeah, and especially the mixed girl is like, "Oh, all of a sudden, I'm the blackest person when it's convenient for you guys."
And the cheating dude, is from
Africa.
So he's like, "You're like." You're like first class
that's
black.
Right.
He's like, my dad's from there. I'm born here.
Yeah, and he's in South Africa, which is has the most white people in
it. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. And then basically it comes down to them
choosing
Clifton because no one really knows
no
who he is,
him.
Basically. And when he was
telling them how he's not the blackest, and he's just like, "Oh, fuck." I forget what he said first, but then he ended up saying, I voted for Trump. And then they all just try to go attack him.
Well, they were surprised.
They're like, "What the hell?" And right as they kick him out, Clifton opens the door, looks back at them, and says, "All lives matter."
that was the fucking best.
Just absolutely pissed off of them. And then we get the live feed show up on the TV. And
he's
leaving
the house.
Yeah.
But I kind of knew something was still up because they try to throw you off with this, obviously.
Yeah.
He got shot in the shoulder.
Yeah.
Buddy just got shot twice.
and he's still there.
And as soon as Clifton goes down, the guy who shoots him drags him off screen.
Yeah.
I was a little tricked, but 2 seconds later, I was like, he's too good of a character.
Yeah, exactly.
He sticks out too much.
I just remembered a line he said that made me fucking die is when... the basement scene when Morgan was in the basement and they shot the lock and the doors just open and it's pitch black. They're going, "Morgan, Morgan." And the nerd goes, "Why don't you try saying your last name?" A lot of funny lines in this.
And he had a lot of lines too when they were playing that made me think it was him too. Like, "Guys, why don't we just play the game?
Yeah, exactly.
Like, do what they say."
Yeah.
Yeah, so he admits, voted for Donald Trump. Clifton goes outside. Eventually, they get split up.
Yeah,
and I think it's right here.
Because the killer gives them a chance now. He says, "I'm going to give you a 3-minute grace period. You can choose either outside or inside."
Because this is when they swipe the board off, and the actual killer with the cool mask is on the screen.
Yeah, and they say, "I don't want to play anymore." And he's like, "All right, you don't want to play anymore? We're jumping to sudden death mode."
Yes.
And this is the
sudden death.
And this is just manhunt.
Basically.
I'm going to hunt you down.
It was pretty sweet.
Yeah.
I liked it. I enjoyed it.
Yeah. They decide to split up.
It was so funny when she's trying to tell them, like, guys, you know what we have to do. And they're like, no, no. She's like, you know what we have to do.
She's driving.
You know what we have to do. And she's like, no, don't say it. She's like, we have to split up. No. Oh, come on.
That's some white people shit.
So, yeah, I think, what do they do? Because some of them go to the basement to find...
to find Morgan.
Morgan or yes. just... Okay.
Yeah.
But then that's where they find his lair.
Because is it ex-Mayo that stays behind? No, ex-Mayo goes outside. Yes. There's...
Yeah, it's ex-Mayo, yeah. the gay guy. Yeah, the gay guy and Allison and the guy cheating. So it's the three people who have drama.
No, the guy with the arrow shot in his arm because he was in the tree later.
Oh, so it's just them two?
No. Mayo, Arrow, King, and was it the gay guy out there?
No, it was just them because she said... Huh.
Is it three and two left?
Okay, maybe another girl was with them?
Adderall girl. That's it.
Yes, that was... Because she kind of gets split up from them. Because she's like, I'm just going to relax here. And you see like all the trippy...
Yeah, she... I forgot why she asked for it. Well, she was asking for painkillers.
Yeah, she asked for painkillers. And we...
Someone just pulls out a prescription bottle.
Yeah, King asks for painkillers. And she gives him the same bottle.
Yeah, yeah.
And he's like... This is Adderall. And she's like, uh-oh. And that's when we see the other... Because the other girl needed painkillers because she fucking stabbed herself.
Oh, that's right. She pulled the arrow out.
Yeah, the second time he got shot, he's like, pull it out. And she pulls it out so fast.
Yeah.
I actually didn't think she actually did that until the next scene where she's like, oh, shit. I'm like, really?
Yeah. Something interesting King was doing. He wasn't even pulling the arrows out. He was breaking them off inside of him.
Well, he broke the front of that one off and asked her to pull it out from back. Oh, I think the first one he pulled it out. Yeah. Like, that's what I mean. God damn. Well, he used to be a thug.
That's
maybe
right.
He's been
getting
shot.
My God. What a life.
Sure.
yeah. So we resolve the outside one first where... X-Mayo decides to swim across the lake.
What would you have done? Because
the
choices were go hide in a tree and basically just wait it out.
Yeah.
Or swim across and keep going for...
Seemingly, she would have... If she kept swimming, she would
100%.
Have made it. Yeah, yeah.
Well, maybe. He could have, like...
Chased her with a...
Kicked King's ass and then shot her.
Yeah. Like, he's using a crossbow. Yeah. Well, he didn't know King was there.
Well, that's what I mean. Yeah. King jumps down and tackles him.
Right, yeah, yeah.
Because, yeah, so X-Mayo starts...
well, first off, the whole X-Mayo with the crossbow, he's shooting at
X-Mayo.
That's
what I'm saying, yeah. He starts shooting her, and she's like, stop it! Just stop it!
She's dodging, like, two arrows.
But then goes underwater, and he's basically just waiting for her to come up, and as soon as she's about to come up, King jumps on him, and she swims back to kind of save him.
And he can't fight at all, too, which is great.
He shot two arrows in his chest.
No. The killer.
Oh, the killer, yeah. Because doesn't this one end up being the one-eyed one?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, so technically, if you can't see number one, and he didn't seem all there in the story, because he doesn't talk or anything.
Yeah, he's one of the mute, dope guys that we see in every horror movie, or one with a family. What's that one? House of a Thousand Corpses?
Yes.
The same sort of, same guy.
Is this the scene they kill him, right?
Yeah, they just beat him to death, essentially.
And then they notice that there's no blood on the shoes. So they actually end up going back to warn them that there's more people.
And so at this point, they're already in the basement. I don't think they've discovered anything.
Well, they've seen the well, which is a crazy fucking well.
Yeah.
It's like the size of my room. Yeah, it's not even round.
Core of the earth.
And it's in the basement. Yeah. And apparently it just doesn't end. Was there was no sound when they dropped things down?
No, he dropped something down there and there really wasn't anything.
I thought I heard a splash, but...
That might explain the ending. We'll get to that.
Mm. Well, when you find out that's where the bodies are going, things could have just been hitting the bodies. But I kept sort of thinking I heard a splash.
Yeah, yeah.
Then I was like, well, maybe that's just my imagination. Maybe that's the point. Like, there's not supposed to be...
Yeah.
Because that's kind of like it. Have you seen the reboot of it?
Yes,
it lives in a well.
Right. Yeah. In the sewers.
In the basement of a house.
Yeah.
Which I don't know if that used to be a thing.
Basement wells. Maybe. It makes sense. You don't want them outside if you want them in.
Well, yeah, like to get water more. Well, maybe it went like wells used to be outside.
Yeah.
And then people started thinking, well, what if we just build the house over the well and have the water in the house?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'd have to look into it because I've never seen a house. Because I've seen houses with wells, but I've never seen an inside well. They might get rid of it at some point. That would stink, I would think.
And like rats or who knows?
Rats and like stale water and shit. But this well's huge.
Yeah. You can't see the bottom of it. And so what happens?
They kill the one guy.
Yeah. Where does the killer come from once they get back? Or does it already try to get to them?
Well, the other guys run into the sheriff again.
That's right.
Yeah, and they all put their weapons down, and they're just like, yeah, so what's up?
Yeah.
And I almost thought he was part of it, too.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's what the movie was definitely trying to allude to, 100%. Is that our main characters did not trust this guy. You don't trust this guy. No one does watching this.
He did seem a little too nice, though. Yeah. Like, I didn't think... I had it in the back of my mind, like, he's too nice to be in on it, sort of, but...
No, the best scene to really make you uneasy is right when they run into him. He has his gun drawn or just a flashlight? I think he has his gun drawn.
I think he has his gun drawn.
Yeah. And so they drop, like, the little vase they have in their hand and everything, the pizza cutter.
Yeah.
and he's like, let me see if I can try to radio someone. And then he goes, White to headquarters.
Yeah.
And they look to each other and like, his name's White? And then she just keeps going, White, White, White. And he's like, oh, weird. This is done by satellite. And it's actually explained why he doesn't get signal. Because was a signal jammer, yeah.
Yeah.
Which was very interesting.
Well, we kind of got that because all of their phones started working as well. That's true, too.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, because satellites would be direct link type thing. Okay.
Yeah.
So he puts them in the car and says,
wait there because he sees two cars ahead of him.
Yeah, I don't know exactly what he saw. Yeah, just two more cars, basically. Because two cars couldn't have pulled up because remember all the cars were... the tires were shot with arrows, so they were there before.
Yeah, yeah.
So I don't know if he saw something and missed it or something.
I think from that shot, we do see the arrows in the tire, too.
Well, that's what I mean. Yeah. Like, they should have already been there. Anyway, this is kind of what made me think that he might be in on it, too, because he puts them in the car. Yeah. Maybe he was going away. It cuts to the people in the forest. We find out that killer is not the only one.
Yeah.
So at that point, we're back to the cop
because
it kind of goes back and forth.
Yep.
That made us think...
Yeah, well, that's the second guy.
It makes you want to think that he's actually maybe over there getting changed. Because I even said that. I was he's getting changed. Yeah. He's going to come. But they find a mask.
Yeah, they look through the glove box and they find the mask that the killer uses. And then immediately when they find it, he comes back and just slams all the windows like, let me in, I'll save you. He's going to get me. And they don't trust him.
I don't think I took him down.
Yeah.
And then he gets an arrow through the throat, I think it was.
Yeah, yeah.
It was a little obscured. Obscured because the window breaks, so you can't really see.
Yeah,
I guess that easy way to not see all the gore or whatever.
And when they try to get out of the car, they do a movie joke where she just keeps hitting the locks on open, close.
Stop hitting the button.
Just go. And then, okay, so how does this wrap up? They jump out of the car.
Well, there's still two killers.
Yes.
So this one, how does he die?
I thought he dies inside. Because she beats him.
Oh, yeah. Because they run back in.
Yes.
So eventually, I don't know what happens exactly from here to...
But that's the final showdown for this guy, for the second killer.
Is the Adderall.
And everything's coming to light with this ex-boyfriend beef and the gay guy and everything. And they start having a spat. And then...
Well, that's after he's been, like, fucking stabbed.
Yeah, yeah.
Because the Adderall girl... Is that Allison or Lisa? I forget. Anyway, she grabs like a bunch of the broken arrow tips and fucking Wolverines it.
Oh, that's
just
right.
Starts like fucking kill. Like,
this scene looked a little lame, I'm going to admit.
No, wait. That was the forest.
That was the forest.
This scene is when...
King doesn't beat him.
Yeah, in the forest, she does the Wolverine thing.
Yeah.
And then here, she's bashing his head in the plastic thing that she had
vase.
Where everyone was like, what are you going
to
do with that? She's like, it's got some weight to it.
And she's...
You got any questions about my choice of weaponry now?
Yeah.
No, you're good. You're good.
It just mangles this guy's face. Yeah, unfortunately, we don't get to see anything crazy gory. They obscure the face. They put him behind the couch so you never see him.
I mean, she has what looks like brain matter all over her. Because even her boyfriend like picks a piece off of her face.
And they look through the... King says, run his pockets. And they look through his pockets and find the ID that looks very similar to the guy they found in the forest.
Yeah, we find out that they were twins.
Yep.
But he also had... I sort of didn't get this. He had a puffer, like an asthma inhaler, with one of their address, like it belonged to one of them.
It belonged to the house. That proved that this was, they own the house that they're staying at, the cabin.
Oh, it was the cabin.
It was the cabin's address.
Oh, yeah. I thought it was one of their addresses. No. Like they had been stalking
them.
She
said that's where we are after they found out the address.
Oh. Yeah. Okay, so we find out that, okay, that is the family's house.
Yeah.
Interest. So you could easily make sequels of this too.
Yeah, and they,
because the dad's still out there.
Yeah,
and you don't know if the other, there's two women in the picture with the family.
Yeah,
I think so. They could still revenge plot.
And you find out, I think, as they're either going through the basement, I think it is the basement, they see a Confederate flag on the side too. So you can tell these two guys are just real.
Yeah, that was quite a little bit ago too.
Yeah,
yeah. When they first find the basement looking for Morgan, they see all like the saw set up and
the
security
chair,
cameras. And I thought maybe this was going on for a while as well, because they have old camera equipment down there and then the newer upgraded equipment.
Yeah,
so it seems like they've been
doing it for a while.
Yeah, at least killing people.
Yeah.
Because we find out finally that, because when they go back to the basement at this point, we see the bodies of poor Officer White and Clifton.
Yes. Yeah.
And even here, I was like, please make him get up.
Yeah, yeah.
I didn't think it was, I'm not going to lie, I didn't think it was going to happen.
Yeah.
But they read a newspaper article or whatever.
That explains that Clifton, it was a police report of a drunk driving incident that Clifton was involved with where he killed a woman.
Killed a woman and was charged with manslaughter.
Yeah, yeah.
So that was interesting. Right there, I was like,
yeah.
That's throwing you for a loop.
At first, I was thinking,
none of them have talked about an incident, but they didn't know about it.
At first, I was thinking that it was somehow like that the murderers were faking police reports and saying like, oh, look, another drunk driver incident. He's in jail now, but actually he's murdered in the well. Mm-hmm. And I wonder if somehow the sheriff.
Oh, that would have been cool.
Yeah, yeah.
That would have been cool.
That was a possibility. Yeah, but then we really...
because that really turned me around.
Yeah.
Sorry to cut you off. Just as soon as they said that, I was like, there's been no mention of any killings or car wrecks or drunk drivers or anything.
And Clifton,
but then when they connected, it's like, oh, that's cool.
And Clifton stands up and puts them all... Well, makes them all drop their guns.
Yeah,
he even gets, though he has nothing, I think.
No, he rigged everything with C4
explosives.
And he has the detonator.
That's right.
Which could have been a bluff.
Honestly, probably was.
Maybe, but he was pretty savvy
because
he had his belt buckle or whatever closed and locked all the doors, and that's how it was happening.
He uses an Android. It's a better OS.
Oh my God, that was so funny.
Yeah, you remember that? There was like a couple scenes where there was like iPhone versus Android thing, and this nerd swore by Android, and everyone else like, we're iPhone here.
Well, it was mostly ex-Mayo.
Yeah,
because even when he gets to the cabin, he's like, does anyone have a charger for
Android?
iPhone? She's like, none of us believe in that or whatever. Like,
we don't believe in that now.
That was fantastic. Yeah, that was in the convenience store they met. Because that's what he says he was there for.
Yeah, an Android church.
His phone died.
And his Hyundai.
And then,
he pronounced Hyundai really weird. He was like, my Hyundai died.
Oh, I was wondering what that was.
Yeah,
I thought maybe it was a GPS or something.
He was trying to say Hyundai.
Okay.
And he's like, my Hyundai.
Yeah, so he has explosives, gets them to kick over the crossbow.
Yeah.
And even here, we get a hint that he hasn't been doing any of the killing.
Yes.
He picks up, he's like, oh,
well,
this is heavy.
Yeah. and he does one final game with them, right? Yes. He says, let's do this again. Because he was really pissed off that when they did it the last time, they... Now, does he explain his whole reasoning here? Right. He says,
no, he does.
Yeah. It's right at the beginning. When they ask, why are you doing this?
Yeah,
and
that's the question he wants to do. He's like, let's play a game.
Yeah.
Why am I doing this?
Yeah.
And none of them can answer, or they refuse, because then he goes to shoot King again, but he ducks, and he's like, the next one's not going to miss.
And then he reveals that, yes, it has to do with the police report, because that's what Allison guesses. She's like, it's a police report, yes. And then he reveals that 10 years ago, they were having a Juneteenth celebration with that same group. And
which was basically probably what was in the picture that they kept
having. Yeah. And
which is probably why it was left in the game room after he had taken out Morgan and
clues.
Sean.
They were playing spades then, and he wanted to learn how to play spades because he grew up in North Dakota, I think.
Yeah, something like that.
And they don't have spades there. So he's like, this is my one time to hang out with people who look like me, and they didn't teach me spades, and then insulted
my
blackness.
Yeah, because he didn't know spades, he wasn't black, and all this.
And
then she's like, well, What did she say? She's like, it's not like we revoked your black card. And he's like, actually, Allison, that's exactly what you said that night.
Yeah.
I believe you said,
I'm revoking your black card. And then that was the first time he drank that night, and he drove home in a rage and it ended up killing a woman and serving 4 years.
For manslaughter. To get away from their meanness. Yeah. I forget the word he uses, but yeah, he just had to get out of there.
Yeah. And so that's his, honestly, cool.
I loved
cool
it.
Reasoning.
I fucking loved it, to be honest.
It wasn't too cheesy, nothing. It was just a very solid, just like, yeah, fair enough.
A little crazy.
A little crazy. Don't kill them.
Well, yeah, a little. Yeah. Well, like, obviously, everyone, it's basically they were a bully to him.
Yes.
So he's getting revenge on his bullies.
Yeah, yeah.
So he is a little crazy.
Yeah, yeah.
But, yeah, fuck, I loved it.
Yeah, and how does that resolve?
And then this is funny because everything, the whole inside joke about the trading glances goes to the whole group.
Yeah.
So it's the two girls, I believe, at first, but then the gay guy and the boyfriend is like...
Yeah. No, hey. I think it was King. It was King and the boyfriend. Or no, the gay guy does.
No, it was the gay guy.
Yeah, so the gay guy...
Because that's the thing, right? These three people with the most drama kind of team up at the end.
And then the buff guy's like, are you talking to me in his head?
And he's like, I didn't know we were able to do this. He's like, yeah, you go low, I go high. Yeah. He's like, no. And they look over and Clifton's just looking at them and he's just like, did you just hear all that? He's like, yeah. I heard the whole conversation. Think you're going to try and take me by surprise. But this whole time, the other two or three people that are outside of the basement are wondering how he locked the doors.
Yes.
And they're watching it on the TV screen and they're like, well, how did he lock the doors when he was with us?
Yes.
So they come to the conclusion that everyone that was in on it has this belt buckle with the knobs that open the door.
Yeah.
And it must have had a screen on it, too, because they're like, all you had to do was three knobs, but they were like going through some sort of list on something like that. They eventually get it. No, they eventually turn the lights off.
That's right.
And that's when they attack Clifton. And do they just push him down the well?
Essentially, a little scuffle, and then he falls backwards and gets dropped down the well in a very weird instance where he falls down the well, and then you hear kind of cackling at
I'm
the
pretty
end of
sure
it.
You did, yeah. Well, like I said, like my theory was if there is a body, like a pile of bodies, maybe he survived.
Yeah, very cool.
Or he just was laughing as he fell to his death. And that's not it.
What happens?
We get a good like 10 minutes of them trying to figure out how to get the cops involved or someone.
Yeah, yeah.
Because they need to tell
how to get help without getting shot. Is that what they mentioned? And they're just all smoking their own individual joints outside too.
And then the gay guy changes.
Does the costume change? Right,
because it keeps going to like the credits for like 2 seconds and then it'll go back and then all of a sudden it goes back once and he's just like in this yellow
this yellow jumpsuit
and they're just like, wait, did you just get changed? He's like, hell yeah, there's gonna be news reporters.
X-Mayo I think says, am I just high or did you do a whole wardrobe change right now? There's gonna be news cameras. And then the firefighters show up and they end up still getting blasted by water.
They get water blasted. Oh, and another thing about the Adderall girl that was hilarious. I think it was when they're in the cabin again.
Yeah.
And they're wondering why she's so whatever.
Yeah.
And X-Mayo's like, oh, it's just because I accidentally gave her Adderall. And she's like, I'm on Adderall. And she's like, no, you're not on anything. And she just puts her hand over her face and she's like, okay.
Her eyes. Just rub. And we missed out on the whole vent sequence.
Yeah, we had another vent, which is funny because we just did a review of Chopping Mall.
Yeah, with Joel
and
the vent.
That was another one where the vent must have been made bigger. Yeah, when they're hiding in there because the gay guy tells them to go and
well,
they
first,
leave.
It's and then we're seeing Lisa and the ex in the vent and they're kind of hashing things over this huge vent on the upstairs. The killer comes upstairs and then a record starts playing. And then the killer goes downstairs to check the record. And the gay guy goes, just shows up at the vent and goes, you're really leaving to die. Let me in there. And he's like yelling.
You said for us to run away. He's like, I didn't mean that. All right, get out of the way. And then they're literally all facing the same way, which would have been impossible to.
Three fully grown people in a vent.
And then you had mentioned the dampener. And this is where it came to play, which was fucking
dampener,
phenomenal.
Did you just say?
Like a signal dampener or killer?
Signal. Jammer.
There you go.
Yeah,
Thank
so the
you.
Killer Whatever. Has a signal jammer that he turns off and all their phones start going off.
Yeah, because they would have a bunch of notifications.
And the gay guy's like, oh, someone liked my Instagram post.
Oh, shit.
We get introduced that the gay guy throws up when he's nervous near the beginning.
Oh, my God.
And then the killer is coming up to the vent, and he just blows chunks all over the killer.
Was he Dwayne?
That might be Dwayne, yeah.
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 Yeah, he was one of my favorite characters as well.
Dwayne Perkins. Oh, it's his real name.
Oh, look at that. Yeah, that was nasty because that was a lot of puke, too.
Yeah, just green.
Oh, is this guy an actual twin?
James Preston Rogers?
Oh, no, it's the...
Oh, he plays both of them.
Yeah, sorry. Which would make sense. All right.
But yeah.
Was there anything else? I don't think so.
No, that just about wrapped it.
That about wraps it up.
Yeah. But yeah, that was a fun flick.
Dude, so
good. It was
good.
Very funny. The action... they were an action director, so whoever was directing it, which is weird because it's Fantastic Four he directed.
Well, yeah, so sort of action.
But I guess they might have been on tightrope with the 14A rating that they really wanted to get.
Oh, 100%. Sure. They were trying to go, like, even being me, I haven't heard a lot of people really talk about this.
Yeah.
And when I've brought it up, they're like, oh, what's that?
Yeah.
Which is funny because when I actually tell them the premise, they're actually like, oh, that sounds like really fucking good. Yeah. So... If you haven't heard of it and are listening to this, go see it.
It
was actually fucking funny. rating time.
Yeah. Do you have a rating?
I do.
What's your rating?
All right. So when it comes down to it, I loved everything about this movie except for the lack of imagination when it came to the kills. I think that's all it was lacking.
Yeah.
But even at the same time, a lot of the kills with the arrows were well done.
Yeah.
Because you'd see the arrows coming at you, or it would always be going by someone else and then hitting someone.
It felt tense always, yeah.
Yeah. Fuck. 4? 4 out of 5.
Mm-hmm. Mine's 3.8 or 3.9.
Of course.
I'm around there. Well, yeah.
You like your points.
I like my points, and I always make good ones. I almost the same reason. The kills, there was certain choreography. The action choreography wasn't that on point for me, but
I thought the first killer went down a little easy, but when you find out they're just dumb rednecks, it's like, they're just normal people.
Although one of them really took an arrow and just kind of didn't flinch, which was, I thought he was supernatural, because he got an arrow like through his stomach and he just turned around.
Well, I mean, one guy gets two arrows in the same hole.
Yeah. These arrows suck. Yeah, 3.8. The action was a little lackluster, and I don't know. I don't think it's because of the director. It could have been the actors. They have no stunt people working on this movie,
the writers,
right? Yeah. Or the 14A rating could have.
100%. I think they were just trying to appease a wider audience. Yeah.
But yeah, over than that, it was so punchy. The acting was so funny. The
comedy was on fucking point.
They played their characters to a T. It was so believable. It was, it was.
And I've heard
enjoyable.
A lot of people say, like, oh, it's very much just like all Cabin in the Woods movies. I don't find, like, there were a lot of good twists in this movie.
Very much so, yeah. Like, it wasn't copy-paste
the
whatsoever.
Entire movie wasn't the board game.
Yep.
Which I kind of thought it was going to be, but they hid it away. And then the last half of the movie is them running through the cabin.
Yeah, and we actually have some protagonists that fight back smartly and then learn and then try to get the jump on the killer.
And I like that everyone in the group, like, kind of...
has their own specific...
way of dealing with what's going on. Like, the one girl's, like, just freaking out. Yeah. Like, ex-Mayo's just like,
doesn't
we just
gotta
fucking deal with
we'll
this
dodge
shit.
Arrows.
Yeah, it was great.
But overall, great time.
Yeah, if you haven't seen it, like I said, go see it. It's still in theaters. You can see it. Sit in the front row if it's the kind of theater that you
please.
Can kick back, put your legs up, eat some popcorn, throw some Whoppers in there, maybe eat some or drink some root beer.
We got a caramel popcorn McFlurry. How'd you enjoy that?
That was pretty good.
Yeah.
How was the popcorn still crunchy? That was crunchier than the popcorn I had at the theater.
Yeah, that's right.
They gave us the stale shit. Son of a bitch. You're lucky I don't come back there.
Now, which movie do you think has more? Django Unchained or this movie?
Oh, Django.
Really? Yeah, you might be right. I know Django hit like what 30
a lot.
Plus? Yeah, it won the record.
Isn't that the movie where Leonardo DiCaprio was like afraid of saying it, and Samuel Jackson was like, "Man, we're fucking actors, dude. Just it's your line.
Yeah,
it's not like you're saying it. It's your character.
Hi, I'm Leonardo DiCaprio. No, great flick.
Yeah. All right. Thank you for listening,
and thank you for listening again.
And hopefully you listen again to Tangents of Horror. And
before that, go ahead.
Follow us on all of our socials. Which ones can they follow us on?
They can do Twitter. They can do Instagram. They can do not Facebook. They can do Spotify. They can do Apple Music.
Yes. You can see us on Twitter, and you can hear what we write on Instagram.
Watch our fan fictions. Right now,
we don't have those yet.
Right now, we're shipping every single character and every single movie that we watch, and we're creating
all
a cinematic
in one
universe.
Big orgy. That's so hot.
It is so hot.
And sweaty.
We think hot, we think sweaty.
All right.
And make sure to always remember the Serengeti.
Yes. Sarah.
Serengeti.
Serengeti.
Sarah getting these nuts.
I ship them. Oh, bye.
Do a big high five.
I didn't want to clip anything.